stand and cast a wishful eye to kingdoms fair and happy land where my possessions lie. I am bound for the promised land, I'm bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. Oh, the transporting rapture scene that rises to my sight. Sweet fields of raving, living green and rivers of delight. I am bound for the promised land, I'm bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. Filled with delight, my raptured soul would hear no longer stay. Oh, Jordan's waves around me roll, fearless I launch away.
Church has this really interesting alchemy going on of both a strong emphasis on justice, a strong emphasis on God's fairness for all, but also one that is done with joy and gratitude.
In many ways, it's about what I call building beloved community. And it has always seemed to me that Union Church is a place that is about building beloved community.
Boundless love, hospitality, kindness, peace, justice, all of the things that we want for our world, this church stands for.
Paul says instead, do what you do. Do what you do for you.
Since coming here, I realized that there is a community that will love you, whether you believe one thing or another. It's that we're worshiping together as a community, that we're giving of ourselves, whether it be as Sunday school teachers or as musicians, sharing our talents or tithing what you can or tithing in other ways, you know, in non-monetary ways.
I give of my time, money, and my spirit, part of the community. I enjoy being part of a faith community.
I give in ways that I can as a student, which is through my creativity.
I sing in the choir. Tom helps with the Sunday school class. We kind of look at it as a give back, because we have received so much.
Union Church works in many areas. We work locally, we work state and nationally, and we work internationally. So some of the folks that we give to are developing communities in El Salvador. We give to Bread for the World. We also give locally. We work with things like our Women's Creative Sewing and Crafts program.
Union Church folks, and probably people in general, are very, very concerned about what goes on in the world and have many things that they could give their money to. You shouldn't give money to anything that doesn't really matter to you. I think you should support Union Church if you care about a future where there might be more peace and more justice. If you want to see that world built, supporting Union Church is a great way to start. And Union Church then can support the next generation and the next generation and the next generation of leaders who will, I hope, bring us closer to that goal.
We want to make sure that the doors are open and all people feel welcome. And anybody is welcome here. And a member is someone who decides, I'm going to be the one to help make sure those doors are open.
It's easy to stay within budget. All we have to do is not do the things that make us a great church. We could cut children's programming, and we could cut music out. We could stop all of that. We spend a lot of money on those things. But we do that because they matter. They really matter. If we stop that just to balance a budget, we're not being the church God calls us to be.
Membership means commitment.
Everyone has a part to play.
Planning means thinking ahead.
Make a pledge, be our future.
Support the church.
And the social justice issues that matter to all of us.
We're serving and loving together.
We're serving and loving together.
We are serving and loving together.
We're serving and loving together.
Union Church is serving and loving together. Will you join us?
She'd meet me when I
Good morning, all. Can you hear me okay? We're just, don't start yet. Oh, don't start yet. Don't start yet. People are coming in. It's all right. I got announcements first. It's all right. Welcome, all. Welcome in. I'm so glad that you all are here. I'm so glad that we could share this beautiful Sunday morning together, and particularly welcome to those of you who hung on after the traditional music festival this weekend and early this morning. We're delighted to welcome you to Union Church, and so glad you could stay around to join us. If you did get here for the music, you know how wonderful it was, and so thanks to our fabulous musicians, and thanks to all of you who made that possible, our sound people and our mic people and our music stand setting up people and all that. Today is also a special day because we are celebrating the life of young people around us. We are celebrating, you are our honored guests this morning, so we're so glad that you're here. And if there are young people around who would prefer to sit on the floor in front, I have put magic carpets and quilts. And if there are people who are young at heart who would prefer rather to be on the floor, you are very welcome to join us up front for this service today. A couple of announcements. In the pews, you will find a red pew folder. It looks sort of like that right there. If you wouldn't mind to fill that out, pass it down the row, and that'll help you and help us welcome everybody who has come. We're delighted that you're here. And if you give us your contact information, somebody will contact you if you would like that. Please just let us know. Also, if you would like a hearing assistance device, we have little hearing aid devices, we have large print bulletins, and if any of those things would be helpful to you or somebody that you came with, we would be delighted to get those to you. They're in the back of the narthex there, and there's also a restroom if you should need it during the service. Let's see, I have very few announcements to share, but first and foremost of all, Chris McKinney, who is our youth director, and this is appropriate on Youth Sunday, we have a trip planned for our young people to a giant corn maze on Saturday, but we need some drivers to help us out. We need drivers to help get us there. So I'm looking for 3 drivers on Saturday. It'll be from 3 until 9 p.m., so it's kind of a commitment. But on the other hand, I know you love the Lord, and I know that you care about kids. So if you can drive on Saturday from 3 until 9 to help get some kids to a great event, please let me know. And if you could raise your hand now or see me later, make sure that I know. We will get you in contact so that we can do that for our kiddos. I have word from Rachel and Leslie. They send their love, and the baby Jack is doing fine, doing well, and so we're thinking of all of our folks out there. And I am apologizing in advance to those of you who are watching this later. We try to webcast our services, but today we're having a technical difficulty, so it will be on delay. It will be recorded, but we will get it up there later in the service. Other things to share today. We have a couple folks in our prayers, and I hope that you would hold those in your thoughts. We are still very much concerned with the destruction of the hurricanes that have come through our southeast, but certainly the Caribbean, and there are more storms a-brewing. You will have heard reports about the typhoon on the west coast today, and we're thinking about that. I do want to say that Church World Service, and through your gifts to One Great Hour of Sharing, which is our national disaster relief offering, things are already cooking. They were able to move blankets and housing units into place before the storms, and so our people are on the ground, and we're thinking about that. But please hold the victims in your prayers. We're also praying today especially for those who are refugees and on the run from various wars and destruction. We looked around all the world. There are more refugees now than there have likely ever been in the history of humanity. We have more people who are displaced from home. So we'll be thinking about that, not just in terms of what, oh, wasn't that a sad thing, and let's do something about that later when we think about it, but also, I hope you will carry that in your heart as ways that you can create home for people around you. There may be people who don't look like a refugee, but perhaps they are in need of some sense of care and compassion, and that's you. That's all of us. So I hope that you will hold that in your living prayer as well. Dodie Murphy is having a few more balance issues today, and so she is home this week, and we're thinking of her. Elizabeth Barrett was taken to the emergency room earlier this week. She had some instability with her brain injury, so we're thinking about Elizabeth. And the evergreen on the altar today is for Chris McKenzie's grandfather, who passed away very unexpectedly. He was 84 years old, died in his sleep earlier Tuesday morning. So our thoughts and prayers are with the McKenzies. He's with them and with family today. So we're praying for all of them. Today, as I said, we're celebrating a special International Children's Sabbath. This is a program that was originally begun by a coalition of not only churches, but synagogues and mosques. It was brought together by Buddhist communities and Hindu communities under the auspices of Marion Wright Edelman. Marion Wright Edelman is the founder of the Children's Defense Fund. And if you're not aware of their work, I highly commend them to you. No one has been more vocal or more of a strong advocate on the issues of child poverty in this country or the issues of how we treat children. If you are a teacher, you know the struggles that some families go through. If you are a person who has ever walked through Walmart, you see that children come in every shape and size, and their parents come in every form of abilities. And the Children's Defense Fund strives to generate a concern and a care for the policies that encourage and bless and raise healthy children. So today we light the justice candle for Marion Wright Edelman, who very famously said, "Children are not our future. Children are our very real and active present." So here is for the blessing of the present. We light our candle this morning for Marion Wright Edelman, and we'll bring that candle down during our processional because it's on the pulpit behind me. Now, as we begin and as we remember children, as I said, there are blankets on the front. If you are a person who likes to wiggle and would like to wiggle more freely up front, you are welcome to do that. In addition, today we're going to be singing a lot of songs that make it easy for anyone of any ability to participate, and our opening hymn is just such a song. I want to teach it to you. You'll find it on page 3. Now, this is a Zimbabwe song. We won't, we will not be singing it in its native language. We'll be singing it just in English, so you're off the hook. And the words are very simple. Come, all you people, come and praise your maker. Come, all you people, come praise your maker. Come, all you people, come praise your maker. Come now and worship the Lord. And this song just repeats, but that allows you to add in harmony. It allows you, if you are not a singer, to do that toe-tapping thing. It allows you, even if you're Presbyterian, to do that clapping thing. People come from a variety of different traditions. We celebrate them all, including God's frozen chosen, however you are so moved this morning. But I invite you to stretch beyond and allow your inner child to play a little bit with this music. This is a great piece. Here's how it sounds. Gabe, would you mind giving a little introduction there? Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come all you people, come praise your maker. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come now and worship the Lord. Perfect. Well, that's it. That's all there is to it. Now, the choir has agreed to provide a parade this morning. And as they come forward, if you would like to join the parade and come sit up here on the front on the blankets, you're welcome to do that. Or perhaps you'd just like to march around and proceed back to your pew. Either way, you are in God's hands. Either way, you are blessed in this place. And no matter whether you are a person of 2 years old or 200, you are welcome in this place. And I hope that today we may lend our spirits to the delight and the joy that is the life of youth and minds. My friends, let us be at peace in this place and let us worship God together. Gabe's going to give us a little musical meditation and then we'll begin with our call to worship. Thank you.
Shall we all rise? Come praise the God, the Creator who made each child in God's image.
We will praise our Creator by recognizing each child's sacred worth.
Come praise the Christ who blessed the children.
We will praise Christ by being a blessing to children in need.
Come praise God, the Holy Spirit who moves among us.
We will praise the Holy Spirit by working for justice.
Come praise the triune God who created us, redeemed us, and sustains us.
We will praise God by putting our faith into action to seek justice for children. Let us worship in spirit and in truth.
Come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come now and worship the Lord. The words repeat now. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come now and worship the Lord. The words the same now. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come now and worship the Lord. Come all you people, come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come now and worship the Lord. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Are you moving? Are you tapping your foot? Are you smiling at your neighbor? Praise your Maker. Come now and worship. One more time. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come all you people, come praise your Maker. Come all you people, come and praise your Maker. Come now and worship the Lord.
Amen. Join with me as we pray together, would you? Merciful God, you call us to create change for children, but we're comfortable with the status quo. You call us to work for justice today, but we put it off until another day. You call us to bring hope, but inside we've really given up on making a difference. You call us to believe in a better tomorrow, but we don't always believe that that's possible. We have broken our covenant of persistent hope in you. Forgive us, we pray, our apathy, for our procrastination, for our resignation, and for our limited vision. Write new words on our changed hearts, O God. Put a new covenant inside us so that we may live boldly into your vision of justice and compassion for every child. Write it so that no one need ask if we know the Lord or if we care for your bright and hopeful tomorrow. Inscribe your word on our hearts and we shall be changed. Amen.
My friends, believe this about the good news. Jesus welcomed every child of God, not just those who were small, but those who were small in hope. All you who come this day, all you seeking redemption, all you looking to bring hope in this world are blessed, forgiven, and freed so to do. For great God Almighty sees each child's heart and welcomes each child here. Let the people say, Amen. Won't you turn to your neighbor, children of God, and welcome each other in this space in Christ's name. Peace be with each and every one of you.
Thank you.
Our choir has, as usual, prepared the Ministry of Music, and we'll turn to them now for our hope and inspiration. In the spirit of a young person's guide to the worship service, do you know why it is, young people, that we have the choir sing? Anybody know? You guys know why we have the choir sing? Anybody know? You guys get a clue? You don't know why we have the choir sing? Any of you know why we have the choir sing? It's a good thing we had this little chat. Well, one of the reasons is because music speaks deeper than words sometimes. Am I right? Music reaches right down, and when you all sing, you all lift our spirits. We have them sing because it feels better than when they don't. So give them a hand. That was good. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. You order our steps and our life. And now, in order to do that best, we're going to have a scripture reading, and Arun is going to bring us the word from Jeremiah.
The scripture portion for today is from Jeremiah chapter 31, and verses 27 to 34. The time is coming, declares the Lord, when I will plant seeds in Israel and Judah, and both people and animals will spring up. Just as I watched over them to dig up and pull down, to overthrow, destroy, and bring harm, so I will watch over them to build and plant, declares the Lord. In those days, people will no longer say, sour grapes eaten by parents leave a bitter taste in the mouths of their children, because everyone will die for their own sins. Whoever eats sour grapes will have a bitter taste in their own mouths. The time is coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the people of Israel and Judah. It won't be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt. They broke that covenant with me, even though I was their husband, declares the Lord. No, this is the covenant that I will make with the people of Israel after that time, declares the Lord. I will put my instructions within them and engrave them on their hearts. I will be their God and they will be my people. They will no longer need to teach each other to say, know the Lord, because they will all know me from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord. For I will forgive their wrongdoing and never again remember their sins. Amen. Amen.
So today, especially, I need young people to help me up here at the front. Not only are we going to talk about this scripture, but I need your help to help me tell the next story. So I need as many people as possible, young and young at heart, to come join us here on the front where already some of the faithful have gathered. Come up front and we'll talk a little bit about Jeremiah and the heart. Good morning, all. Good morning, good morning. I'm so glad you're here. Thank you all. Oh, come, come, come. Yep, plenty of room, plenty of room. We got carpets. Oh, we got puppets. We got things to go. Good, good, good. Well, like I said, today is a special day, and thank you, not just for being here today, but thank you for whenever you come, because you know why? You all are so important. You matter. It matters that you're here. You know what? I like it when you smile. I like it when you make noise. I like it when you color. I like it all. I like what you bring. I like the energy that you bring to this place. You know why? Because I am old. Because I am old, and sometimes I am tired. Oh, I am tired. And do you know what happens when you get old and tired? Sometimes you get cranky. Have you ever seen this in people you love and know? Have you ever seen anybody in your life get cranky? You have. Aha, aha, aha. The truth is coming out. Yes, exactly, exactly. So what is the antidote to cranky, my friends? What is the antidote to cranky? Oh, this is important. Do you know? Do you know? What? What do you think? Energy can be an antidote to cranky. What were you going to say, Matthew? Love is always a good antidote to cranky. Yeah. Oh, yeah. What? Anything else? I got one in my head. Good humor. Good humor. Oh, a good joke is a good antidote to cranky. Am I right? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Try that on somebody. If some parent of your acquaintance, unless it's very bad cranky, in which times sometimes thoughtful silence is... and a slow backing away, right? Sometimes that's best, right? Sometimes you just need to let people, okay, maybe mom and dad just need a little time out, you know? They just need a little, right? Sometimes you have to love them through the cranky, right? That's true. Well, Jeremiah had a bunch of cranky people.
Jeremiah was writing to a bunch of people. They had treated each other bad. They had spit in each other's faces. They had pulled each other's hair. They had pretended that they didn't exist or didn't like each other. And then God said, look, you treat each other bad. You cannot be my people. You're making me crazy. You're going into exile. Everybody needs a little time out. And he sent them into time out in a whole other country, right? And they got depressed, because they didn't want to be away from God. They didn't want to be away from the home. They didn't want to be away from their people. And yet there they were. A foreign nation came in, wars, the whole bit, soldiers. They captured them, took them off. And they made them walk like, I don't know, it's like 1,000 miles that they had to walk. And they had to live there 75, 80 years. Now you aren't even like, some of you aren't even like, you know, 25 years old. You're not 25, are you yet? No, okay, phew. Good, because I knew I was old. I just wasn't sure. Right, yeah, okay. No, imagine, it took them as long to walk there as some of you are alive, right? They were a long way from home. They were tired. But Jeremiah had this word. Jeremiah said, look, you guys didn't know what you were doing. You guys didn't act right towards each other. And you made me very, 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 very cranky. But... You know what God said to the people? Oh, okay. Well, the things that you just said. God said, I've got some energy for you. I've got some love for you. I've got some good humor for you. Here's the love. The love is, it's not always, you're not always going to have to spend time in your room. And here's the other thing. Here's the other good news. Even though you made me crazy, I still love you so much that I couldn't possibly give you up. And so here's what I'm going to do. We had a promise. We broke it. It wasn't good. That's not right. Anybody here ever broken a promise? I kind of have. No? Not yet? Oh, God bless you. No. Keep up. Keep it up. Keep up the good work. Yeah, it's really hard. But sometimes I've just felt terrible, right? There's been promises I have not been able to keep. God says, here's the thing. Instead of promises that you write down on a piece of paper so that you can remember, I'm going to write it somewhere you'll never forget. Right, on your forehead backwards so you can read it in the mirror. Okay, no. No. Where did God write the promise, right? God says, I will write this covenant of love between you and me, I will write it here on your heart. It's going to be like so much a part of you. Do you all think about your heartbeat right now? Put your hand on your heart there. You can do this too. You can be children at heart. Right? Nobody goes around every day and goes, oh, I got to remember to have my heartbeat. Oh, God, what time is it? 3:00? Oh, I forgot to let my heart beat. Right? It doesn't happen. Right? Your heart just goes thump, 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 thump. And you don't have to think about it. It just comes up and out of the, because your heart is your heart. It knows what to do. And God says, I'm going to make our promise of love like that. It's going to be like that. I'm going to be thump, thump. Just as easy as you don't have to think about your heart beating, you don't have to think about breathing in to stay alive. So it is when you breathe out, you're going to breathe out love just as easily as you have breathed in the air. And everybody will be treated fairly, and everybody will be given justice, and everybody will have a good humor, and nobody will have to be cranky. And everybody who wants to vote for that, raise your hand. Amen. Yeah, exactly. The idea was that we're supposed to live in that kind of grace, that kind of energy, that kind of love that you're talking about, so that everybody can be treated right. Everybody can have what they need. Now, later on in the prayers, right, you've been to church before, most of you, right? And you know that we always pray this prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. And in that prayer, which we call the Lord's Prayer, Jesus says, pray like this. Ask for your daily bread, right? Ask for daily bread. Ask for daily bread. But it's not just the bread you need for eating. It's also the things that make you strong. Now, what kinds of things make you strong that's not about strong in your body? Well, what do you think? What makes you strong? What does? Green beans make you strong. Absolutely. Right. What else? Carrots make you strong. Absolutely. What kinds of things that aren't food make you strong? Watermelon is a food, but it makes you strong. Absolutely. What makes you strong? What makes you strong?
Exercise.
Exercise makes you strong. What else? What were we going to say? Stuff makes you. What kind of stuff? Does every stuff make you strong? Because, some stuff makes you weak, right? Right? If you have too much stuff, you get weak. right? Because your wallet gets weak and your mind gets weak, right? There's certain kinds of stuff that makes you strong. What kind of stuff makes you strong? Yeah, Matthew. Cheese makes you strong.
I love this.
Absolutely. Cheese got protein, right? Okay, what kinds of things in your heart make you strong? The air, okay? Air makes you strong. You gotta breathe in, yeah. What else?
Playground,
right? Play makes you strong. Well, how does play make you strong? How does play make you strong? You all play video games, right? No, you play outside games? You play tag? You play Dungeons and Dragons? You play World of Warcraft? You play, what do you play? Right, all these things? Why does play make you strong? I'll tell you, yeah, you got an idea? It helps your muscles, and it also helps your mind. When you exercise your mind, when you try out something new, you are building neurons. You are creating possibilities. Let's say you're playing on the playground and you guys decide you got a game and there's lava and you got to stay off the lava and you got to jump from rock to rock and all that. You ever play that game? Hot Lava or Deadly Sharks? Yeah, baby, that's right.
Yeah,
right. Play is a way in which we rehearse the things that matter. So in play, when you're helping somebody stay out of the lava, you are rehearsing your compassion. When you play at a game that wounds somebody, that's not so good. Maybe you're rehearsing how you're going to be mean to somebody. You don't want to do that. So the way you play matters. But play is a way that we get to be somebody that maybe we're not right now. So are you a business executive right now? Do you own a bank? Yes, I do. Yes, indeed, she does. Absolutely, right. Or maybe you want to play at being an artist, right? Play is important. Play matters, and play builds your strength. God says, "I'm going to make it strong in you. I'm going to make you strong." And it doesn't mean that means you have to be serious and you have to be sad and you have to be depressed and you have to be cranky. Strong means you have to be fluid and laughing and supple and right and good with the world and able to help other people. Yeah. Yeah, like, you know, cats on your head. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. And there's a reason you have to be strong. There's a reason you have to be strong. You got to have muscles for your body. You got to have muscles for your heart. You got to have a mind that's keen and accurate. You got to practice your schooling. You got to practice your loving. You got to practice taking care of your body. Why is that? You know what? Old people can answer this. You're too young to know. Why do you have to take care of all these things, older, seasoned people? Why does that matter? Because you want a healthy life, right? Healthy life matters, and it doesn't always get easier. What's another reason that you need a keen mind and a good heart and the ability to keep strong? Yeah, eating healthy food matters. Why do you think?
Don't eat candy.
Right, you gotta keep away from all the stuff. You can have a little, but you can't have a lot. Okay, you got an answer right over here?
Because the work can be really sad sometimes, and it takes a lot of love.
Yes, stand up and say that again. Because the
work can be very sad sometimes, and you need to work really, really hard to love people when the world is sad.
The world can be really, really sad and hard sometimes, and you need to be the brightest you can be, the strongest in the heart you can be, and the best in your body you can be to love people when they are sad and when the world hurts. It's not just about you. It's not just about me. It's not just about us. It's about the whole world needs you to be wise and healthy and strong and loving. Somebody in this room is going to change this world. Somebody here, I'm not kidding you, somebody here is literally going to grow up and they're going to start a business, or they're going to educate a child, or they're going to run for office, and they're going to make a good difference in this world because you were smart and you were loving and you were careful about the way you took in what everybody told you, right? If you rehearse your compassion, if you love, if you practice loving, if you practice playing at what is good for the world is a hurting place sometimes. And when we help each other, Jesus, that's the whole reason we gather in church, is to remind each other that we are each other, that we are with one another. So it matters that you come because you are bright and you are smart and you are healthy and you bring energy and love to this place. But it also matters that you come because you help us stay that way. You help us old and cranky people be a lot stronger than we might otherwise. So I want to know, will you help me? I have a project. Instead of going back for children's moment after this, I want you to help me tell the gospel. Will you help me?
Yeah.
Because there's a story, all right? And I need teams, okay? I need a team of persistent, strong-minded, justice-seeking people. I need a team. I need half of you to be the team widow. Will you be team widow? Who will be team widow? Yep, one, two, three, okay. I need a couple guys. We need some strength. These guys right here are going to be it, okay? All right, team widow, would you come over here and stand by the candle? Okay, all right? Okay, I need everybody else to come stand over here, and you are going to be with me team judge, okay? Team judge. Now, judges are smart. Judges sometimes are, they're the ones who help us solve problems. We got team widow over here. We got team judge over here. And I'm going to need somebody to help me because right here, we have the door. All right? Okay, one door. All right? Judges, you are going to be behind this door on this side over here. So you can squish over this way a little bit more. Okay, very good. So here's our door, right? Right here. This is a story that Jesus told about a judge. Here they are. And the judges had worked very, very hard all day. They had tried cases. They had heard people. They had gotten old, and they had become cranky. All of them. So can you be old and cranky? Oh, that's good. Yeah, you got the cranky. He's got the cranky thing down. Oh, no, I saw it. I saw cranky. All right. All right, imagine that you are cranky. Imagine that it has been a long day, and now you are home, and you have put on your fuzzy bunny slippers, and they are sitting up in the reclining chair. You got your bunny slippers on? Yeah. You have got your fuzzy robe on. You are watching Netflix, and no one is going to bother you when, just at that time, the widow, team widow. Stand up, you guys. You guys did not, you were not allowed in court. And you guys have a genuine grievance. It is really not your fault. It is really something that you need. And so you guys come knocking at the judge's door late at night. Will you come knock on this door? Somebody come knock on this door. Right here. Everybody knocks. Keep knocking. Oh, yeah. She didn't quit. She did not quit. And you know what the judges said? All right, you have to repeat after me. I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. All right, let's try it together. Ready? I hear you knocking, but they can't come in. And the widow woman said, no, I need justice. I need you to help me. And they kept knocking. Knock again. Keep knocking. Keep knocking, keep knocking, keep knocking, keep knocking, guys, keep knocking, keep knocking. You gotta keep knocking. They need more help, more knocking, more knocking. And the judges said, what did the judges say? I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. But you know what? Did the widow people go away? Did they go? They're still there. They're not going away. And the judge said to him, hey, I'm watching Netflix. I got my bunny slippers on. I go come back tomorrow. And what did widow people do? They just kept knocking. And the judge said, I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Okay, stop.
And you're going to break that door.
Except that.
You're going to watch Netflix.
You know what? She did. Did she ever go away? Did you guys go away?
No.
No. No. In fact, the judge had to get up, and the judge opened up that door, and the judge standing there in those pink slippers and with the hair all goofy from laying in front of the couch, right? Right? The judge said, you know what? You're driving me nuts. The judge said, widow people, oh my gosh, will you stop knocking? And you know what the widow people said? We can't stop until we get what is just and right and loving and fair. And at that point, the judge said, all right, I hear you. I don't really like you. I don't really know you. I don't know what it is you think you want from me, but I tell you what, just because you are making me crazy, and you are so persistent, and you have been so strong, and your love will not quit, I will grant you justice. I hear you knocking, and I will give you what you need. What happens? How do the widow people feel at that point? Happy people. All right, let's see some happy. Let's see some happy widows. No, show them. Whee! Right. And the judge, turns out the judge got to be happy too. Do you know why? Because the judge could finally go back to sleep on the couch and said, phew. Now here's the thing. Judge people, widow people. You can sit down. Judge people, widow people. The world needs people who've got love that is strong enough to keep knocking. Because sometimes what people need, others cannot hear, or they're already so comfy that they don't want to get up, right? Right? This is for the, I need to have an adult moment, do you mind? Okay, this is adult moment, here we go. Adult moment. Think about this with the way we treat children, right? Children who represent not just our future, but are our present. Individually, we love kids. But on a societal level, we don't do so good. About 25-30% of children in this country live in poverty. Do you hear me knocking? 25% of our children live in poverty? In the richest nation in the world? Is that okay with you? Do you hear me knocking? Do you know of the UN Convention on Human Rights for Children, the only country that has not ratified the treaty? That's the United States. Do you know why? Well, because it says in there that it shall be illegal for member signatory states to put to death children under the age of 16. And our Congress wouldn't sign that. Societally, we have to change our hearts. Societally, we have to say, we hear people knocking, and we have got to get up wearing our fuzzy slippers. We have got to march to the door, muting the Netflix, and we have got to enact the justice that God has written on our hearts. The justice that we would give to our own children right here. We have to write it large. We have to write it on our policies. We have to write it in the way we treat people. She won't talk about this. Leslie Smallstokes, one of the many people in the last 6 months. We've had 5 babies born in this congregation in the last 6 months. Fewer than 20% of American corporations give any kind of maternal leave at all. 20%. Leslie happens to be at a Catholic hospital, faith-based organization, that has dedicated itself to children in Louisville. They do not offer maternity or paternity leave at all. What is wrong with this picture? Oh, we love children, but do you hear them knocking? Healthy children need healthy adults. The reason we're having a children's Sabbath today is not for you guys, because you guys are awesome. You guys have been great widows. You guys have been great judges. But now you guys have to decide if you are going to be a great people. We have to decide if, in fact, we are going to not just talk about kids, but, in fact, support and sustain our whole world by sustaining the youth within us and the youth around us. So I say this. I think we should all knock on every door we can when there's people who need help. Yeah? I think you need to have the brightest mind and the brightest head and the strongest body and the best possible heart to keep knocking on those doors. Because the door that the world is knocking on isn't God's, it's yours and mine, right? It's our door. We are telling a story about how it is that love wins. Love wins because there are strong, loving people who keep at it. Do you hear me knocking? Do you hear me knocking? Do you hear me knocking? I don't hear you. Do you hear me knocking? Do you all hear me knocking? Let the people say, amen. Thanks you all. Thank you all for coming up and being our preachers this morning. Thank you all. Would you give these fine young ministers our hands? God bless you. Thanks, you guys. May God's blessings guard, protect, and guide you. God bless you. God bless you. Our Savior's loving arms be ever around you. God bless you. God bless you. I invite you to join with us in our hymn now that's just titled right there, Somebody's Knockin'. And Gabe wanted me to let you know that those first three lines are the chorus. We'll start with the chorus and then the verses are below and we'll sing the chorus in between. And you can just remain seated as we do. Well, my friends, you know that this is October, and those of you who are longtime attenders will know that October is that most dreaded of all seasons, stewardship season. It is the time when we come knocking at your door for a little hope and a little challenge. This year, we've got a challenge before us. We want to plan thoughtfully, carefully, compassionately for the way we do our work next year. So send no money now. Nothing is required of you now, everything by compassion, nothing by compulsion, but this. If we don't think and plan for how we're going to act and be a hope in the world, it doesn't happen. Things don't just fall neatly into place. Sometimes we have to struggle and strive. And so, with your offering today, we will struggle and we will strive for not just these children, but all children. With your pledge coming up at the end of the month, at the end of the month is when we're taking in pledges, at the end of the month, we're going to pull our resources together and guess what we're going to be able to put to it in 2017. By compassion, by wise heads, by good thoughts, by strong work and careful expertise, we're going to make a difference in this world. So think, pray, and then act on all that. And let us receive this offering today with joy and thanks for the future that is in our very, very midst. Amen.
Amen. As Arun heads to the peace bell, let me invite you to be at peace in this place while we offer our prayers and blessings. Sometimes, and this is for all of us to remind ourselves, sometimes prayer is quiet and it's the silence that speaks to us in our hearts, and sometimes prayer is the actions we take. And in this moment, it's just a chance to connect with God, to find a little quiet in the midst of a lot of people, and to find that voice that rises within. So I invite you to be at peace, knowing that you are in God's presence, knowing that you are always in God's presence here or wherever you find yourself, still and quiet or up and jumping, but allowing yourself to be aware of it, to be aware of it like you were aware of your heartbeat before. Let prayer just flow into and out of you like breath as we pray together.
As we pray, we lift our prayers for those who have come today as strangers and guests to this congregation. We pray that God's people may sustain them, that God's words may inspire us together, and that the love of Jesus be shown to all. Remembering our world and all local churches as part of our ecumenical prayer cycle, we lift in our prayers the people of Armenia, Azerbaijan, Georgia, the friends and members of Berea Friends Meeting, who are our sisters and brothers. that the hand of God will always cradle and guide us all, and that the works of God will be our yeast and our pearl. Lord, we carry in our hearts the joy and concern of so many in our midst, some we have named, others whom only you know. Hold and heal us all, named and known to you in body, mind, and spirit. We gather one and all that we may be made one in communion with you. O God, help us to recover our hope for our children's sake. Help us recover our courage for our children's sake. Help us recover our discipline for our children's sake. Help us recover our ability to work together for our children's sake. Help us to recover our values for our children's sake. Help us recover our faith for our children's sake. God and community, holy in one, this we pray as Jesus taught us, reaching to you as our Maker, our Mother, and our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth
as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the
glory forever. Amen.
I invite you to rise and join in our closing hymn, which again is just simple and repetitive. We'll just sing it a couple times through. It's printed in your bulletin, and I invite you to rest on your feet. Children of God, may you know the love and hope and freedom that God intends, not just for you, not just for the people who look like you, but for all God's children. May power and love and grace be so inside your heart that you need not think about offering it to others, that it simply wells out of you like the breath of welcome. My friends, this day and every day, may there be a Sabbath, a healing, and a wholeness for the children around us, and the children within us, and all the children of God. Let the people of this world say, Amen. My friends, go this day in peace, for the Lord dances and plays before you in the fields of the Lord. Amen.
There are coffee and snacks and some child-friendly treats if you would like to join us in the parlor. If you can linger, if not, may God bless you on your way.